Hello, welcome to Newsflash Africa, the best place to get Africa-related content. In today's news,
Alain Onyema, the Nigerian aviation executive who was recently accused by the United States of committing more than $21 million fraud, will spend up to 105 years in prison if convicted of laundering charges bordering on alleged fraud. Mr. Onyema was indicted by the federal grand jury in the United States on November 19. On multiple charges bordering criminal conspiracies, bank fraud, and also money laundering, according to the initial report by the U.S. State Department and U.S. Department of Justice. The full statement, which was obtained by some news agencies, stated that Mr. Onyema was indicted on one account of conspiracy to commit bank fraud, three accounts of bank fraud, and one account of conspiracy to commit credit application fraud. The airpiece chairman was also charged with three counts of credit application fraud and 27 counts of money laundering. Mr. Onyema faces a total of 35 counts, each criminal in nature, and carries specific penalties that involve either a hefty fine or jail sentence or both. The charges were far greater than those leveled against Mr. Onyema's alleged accomplice, Ejirogene Egehaha, AP's head of finance and administration. Mr. Egehaha was slammed with one account of conspiracy to commit bank fraud, three counts of bank fraud, and one count of conspiracy to commit credit application fraud, three counts of credit application fraud, and one count of aggravated identity theft. Both suspects denied the allegations in November 23rd statement and indicated their readiness to file the charges in court. Neither Mr. Onyema nor his lawyers have said anything about whether or not he will be going to America to defend the charges or when, but details already made available by the US authorities have provided a very good idea of potential penalties that could be coming forth from the charge. According to the indictment, Mr. Onyema, aided allegedly by Mrs. Egehaha, raised several letters of credit to buy the same planes he had already purchased and added to Airpeace fleet of commercial airliners in Nigeria. Based on dubious letters of credit, American banking agent Wells Fargo transferred more than $21 million to bank accounts of US-based Springfield Aviation, a suspected shell company registered and controlled by Mr. Onyema. Wells Fargo paid the money to Mr. Onyema in a series of transactions between February 10, 2017 and February 20, 2018, court documents said. Mr. Onyema then allegedly transferred the funds to different bank accounts in a series of 27 transactions between March and November 2017, the document said. As part of the investigation, American authorities have already frozen bank accounts allegedly owned by Mr. Onyema in US and Canada, trapping about 5 billion naira, about $14.2 million. In a cross-border measure. The indictment said the final forfeiture of funds will be pursued as a part of potential penalties against Mr. Onyema. Since the businessman has not been formally arraigned in court, prosecutors have yet to disclose possible sentences or fine. But based on the counts already leveled against him, Mr. Onyema could be sentenced to 105 years, including sentences that may run concurrently. The maximum penalty for bank fraud, Title 18, Section 31444, is 30 years. Mr. Onyema was slammed with three counts of this, which means he would face maximum of 90 years on bank fraud charges. But since the charges are likely to run concurrently, it means 30 years will be maximum. Mr. Onyema is facing federal charges, and most of the officials responsible for his investigation and indictment are from federal agencies. However, additional factors may play out depending on how this case proceeds. This includes whether Mr. Onyema would likely ask his lawyer to negotiate a soft landing for him and the discretion of the judge that will be assigned to the case. While analysis have showed that actual sentences for federal crimes are usually less than the maximum penalties prescribed by the law, the federal judge that will be assigned to the case will try and determine how lengthy a sentence for a successful count will be after taking into account the federal sentencing guidelines and other statutory factors. Well, we have seen that Mr. Onyema has claimed that he is innocent of all these charges that have been leveled against him, and he said that he was actually planning to go to the US to actually clear his name, but then we are suddenly finding out that he has decided to go to Nigerian courts to prevent an extradition of him being forcibly taken from Nigeria to the US in order to face the justice system over there. So that comes as a bit of a surprise for someone that claims to be innocent. Although many people on social media are saying that possibly the man was actually washing the money or money laundering money for Nigeria treasury looters. Well, I personally do not believe that to be the case, because the case against Mr. Onyema is well documented and is also found to be the sole signatory in all the accounts, and occasionally adding his wife. Also, the companies that were also involved were either private companies or charities, which all seem to be his own since he's the sole signatory. But this seems to be a serious bone of contention in the social media, especially for Nigerians, because some are saying that this has to do a bit of motive comes into play, that the FBI has an ulterior motive in charging Mr. Onyema for these charges. Well, in all honesty, if he was to be charged these same charges by a Nigerian court, and let's say by the EFCC, well, people would definitely say that this is a witch hunt, or that because he's Igbo, because he sympathized with the PDP. But now, since he's coming, he's being charged by the American federal agencies. But I believe that the charges that are brought up Mr. Onyema and the assistant, I believe that that is not the full scope of the investigation. I believe many more people are involved, and possibly they gave the assistant much fewer offenses as an incentive for the person to cooperate and testify against Mr. Onyema. And this is very popular in the American system. They always do this. They always give the underling much fewer offenses to incentivize them to snitch on their so-called boss. So who knows, maybe that might also be at play here. Well, we can all just sit down here and speculate about the motive, but one thing we know for sure is that the American authorities have pressed these charges against Mr. Onyema. And these are the facts. Those are the facts we know for sure. Well, those are my thoughts on the matter. Please do join me for future videos.
If you enjoyed this video, please like, drop a comment below, and also subscribe to be notified of future content.